How do we get something from the user in Scratch and Python? When we get something from a user in Scratch, we use ask and wait, and in reply it comes back to answer. We have very similar thing in Python. We have input. So we ask the question, what's your name, for example, and then the user replies, and what they enter in goes into a variable which we could call answer the same. Sometimes in Scratch we want to get something from the user, and we can use the ask and wait and answer. So here we're going to ask, what's your name, and wait. And then once we get a reply, we can say that. So let's put that in there. So ask, what's your name, and wait. Say answer for 2 seconds. So when we run that, let's have a look. What's your name? Dr. Codie. We run it, Dr. Codie. So that's pretty straightforward. We ask, what's your name, and wait. The reply goes into the answer, and that's straightforward. In Python, we have something quite similar called input. So rather than ask and wait, we use input. We still have the question, what's your name, and answer we can print. So if we run that, we can put in Dr. Codie. Enter, and it will print it. So we don't need to use answer. We can choose any variable name. We could change this, for example, just down to A, just to show you that we don't need to use answer. And then we can run that, and it will still work. Here we've entered Alan. So we don't need to use the word answer, but Python here, using input, is very similar to ask and wait in Scratch. Let's try this again with a number. So instead of asking, what's your name, we're going to ask, what's your number? And instead of just replying and saying the answer, we're going to do something with it. So let's multiply the number by 2. So we're going to ask the user to enter a number in, and then we're going to reply with the number multiplied by 2. So we're going to enter in the number 7. So let's run this. What's your number? We enter in a number 7, and it says 14. So again, straightforward, we request the user to put something in. Last time they put a string in, a name, this time they put a number in. Very straightforward in Scratch. There is a difference in Python though. In Scratch we could use the string, like a name, and a number the same, but in Python we can't because of types. Let's show you what I mean. So we have print A here, and after I'm going to ask to type, to print the type of A. So let's just change this back to answer. So we're going to get the answer from the user, and we're going to print it, and then we're going to print what type it is. So what's your name? We're going to ask for a name. Let's try Alan again. So Alan, and you see there it says class string. Now let's change it to a number. So now we're going to run it again. What's your number? Put 7 in. 7, it's still a string. So be careful here. If we try to put answer equals answer times by 2, like we did before in Scratch, Let's run this. What's your number? 7. We've got answer 7, answer by 2. But what happened there? Let's print it and see what happens. So let's run this again. What's your number? 7. 7's gone in, but look, it's given us 77, not 14, because it's still a string. The character 7 has been multiplied by 2. So if we try to add 2 and run the program, now what's your number 7? It's got an error message saying we can't put together, concatenate a string and an integer. So what can we do? What we can do, we can change the type. So now, when we get the answer, we know it's going to be a number. We can change it to an integer, for example. So let's say answer equals integer of answer. So now, instead of being a string, we're changing it to an integer. Let's run that. Let's see our number 7. So it's gone to 7. Add 2 is 9, and now you can see the class, meaning it's an integer, not a string. Sometimes people might put in a different number, so you might want to use float. It will still work. So let's put in 7. So you can see now we've got 7.0 and 9.0. So we can change a string to an integer or a float, or even an integer or a float to a string by using this code. So when you get something from a user, it's always a string. If you want to do some math with it, change it to an integer or a float. Okay, thank you for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. Bye for now.